His roar is legendary. His 7'4" stature is towering. His temper, like an Afghan hound with ADHD, is probably the worst in the galaxy. Yes, Chewie, Chewbacca, the walking carpet Wookiee, co-pilot to Han Solo.
Laugh it up, fuzzball.
But what of the English fella behind the fur, the humble hospital orderly born with a crippling condition of gigantism, to which he owed his famous height, but now to his creeping debilitation? As reports and rumours swirl about Peter Mayhew reprising the hair suit for a role in the new Star Wars Episode 7, I sat down to punch it with Chewie and asked him how he first came to meet George Lucas.
My name was put forward to someone working on a sci-fi movie. That's all he was told. Walked into George's office. On one of the walls, there was all the characters drawn.
And do you think that you might be an Ewok at
I
that time?
Know. I thought he might chop me in three, but within 3 weeks, we were actually filming.
Surely it must have been pretty uncomfortable. Did you have to wear a suit underneath?
I had a leotard underneath, which absorbed all the sweat.
Take care of yourself, okay?
It was mohair with yak hair through it, and it was knitted by little old ladies on big knitting needles, you know, size of drumsticks almost.
I also read that you went to the zoo to try and take cues off animals to get the right animal feel. Yep. What animals inspired you the most?
The growling variety. So it was bears, dogs, trying to protect a noise through a mask. It's like wearing a motorcycle helmet with the visor down and you're trying to talk.
No one can hear you scream.
Nobody could hear you scream.
But after the highs of shooting the first three films, Mayhew returned to Yorkshire to live a reclusive life out of Hollywood spotlight.
Close friends knew what I was doing. The rest of the world can go hang. Because if you know me, Hollywood life does not suit.
Soon enough, though, the enduring success of the franchise drew him back. Plus, there was the opportunity to meet his idols. So, who does a Wookiee idolise?
Henry Winkler, who played the Franz. We were at a convention, and he came over. And I thought, here we go.
I'm losing my cool.
He said, how's your niece? I said, they're fine. They're almost $6 million. All of a sudden, I get a hand on my shoulder. It's nearly as expensive as mine. It was Lee Majors.
Well, Chewie meets the $6 million man. You don't get that every day.
That's... No, exactly. And it was click, 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 click.
I don't want to hurt you. I'd like to thank the feelings mutual.
Mayhew attends up to 20 conventions every year, despite his ailing health. The dazzling array of merch for sale and $50 a pop photos, the mainstay of the circuit.
It's been going for four generations. Come on, what other movies or series, even television, has gone four generations?
Do you think that there will ever be a set of films that has captured our imaginations as much as Star Wars did?
Well, Star Trek tried.
But failed.
But failed miserably.
You're going to piss off a lot of Trekkies right now.
So